إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from our sins and bad deeds. He who is guided by Allah indeed has been guided, and he who is misguided, only Allah Azza wa Jalla can guide him. And I bear witness that there are no deities to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon Sayyidina Muhammad, upon his family, upon his companions, and upon those who follow his sunnah until the day of judgment. The best words are the words of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran al-Kareem, in mentioning the month of Ramadan and mentioning fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a glimpse of how to. But then some words, three particular words, concerning the understanding of what fasting is about. So it is, there is always an internal dimension and an external dimension. An external dimension to the deeds that we do, meaning in the way of fiqh, and an internal dimension in the way of heart and intention and understanding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used three words, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. In the same ayat, it began with يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ, all the way to the end of the ayat, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. And then in the middle of the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Then at the end, in the dua, the famous dua, إِذَا سَأَلَكَ عَبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ, at the end of this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. So the taqwa and the shukr and the rushd is a concept to be understood, to be researched, to be looked at, because it is an internal issue. And the internal issue is very important, because after all, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ, أَعْمَالُ is according to intention, intention is the work of the internal work. So today we stop at لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So you may reach a level of shukr. Okay, so what is shukr? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Insan, said that إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. We guided them or him to the path, meaning mankind, to the path. Either he is shakir or kafur. Kafur meaning exaggeration of kafir, right? So shakur is have gratitude. Kafur is ingratitude. But shakur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then make it equal to iman. And kufr ni'mah is about to take one to kufr as well. Right? So inna a'tadna lil kafirina salasila wa aghlala wa sa'ira. The ayah after it. Okay? The ayah about the kuffar, what we prepared for them in hellfire and so forth. So shukr is equal to iman here. Okay? So as Imam al-Harawi rahimahullah in his book Manazil al-Sahirin, he made I give a definition, his own definition to shukr. He said, huwa ismun